A very good morning to the guest of honor of today's program, Mr. Shishir Joshipura, the chief guest, Mr. Anand Tayavlikar, Leela Mom, Firoz Rad, the advisory board, trustees of the Leela Poonawalla Foundation, committee members, other distinguished guests, members of the press, Leela fellows, Leela girls, and their families. I would now like to call upon Chaitali Merin, Simali Bhavna Reshma, Jayashri, and Madhura to present the song before you. These girls are not professional singers but are a part of the Leela Poonawalla Foundation.
I am born with goodness and trust. I am born with ideas and dreams. I am born with greatness. I am born with confidence. I am born with wings. So I am not meant for crawling. I have wings. I will fly and fly. These great lines were said by our very own Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, commonly known as the Missile Man of India, whom we have recently lost a few months back. He was the man who supported the youth and its education throughout his life.
Do you know why we have chosen this odd date, that is the 30th of October, for the scholarship award ceremony? This is only because Dr. A.B.J. Abdul Kalam had given this day to the foundation to be a part of this celebration as our chief guest. Thus, neither we have changed the date of the function, nor are we going to forget this great personality.
Thus, today, we would all like to remember him and his dreams. I invite Joe Otagri, Leela Fellow 1998 and Peace Ambassador 2009, to give the legend a tribute on behalf of all of us.
Good morning, everyone. The Leela Poonawalla Foundation today pays tribute to the greatest icon of this century, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. As we all know, Dr. Kalam was the 11th President of India. One amongst the most respected people of India, Dr. Kalam contributed immensely in India's nuclear mission, especially in the field of missile development. Thus, he was fondly called Missile Man of India.
Guest of honor, Mr. Shishi Joshipura, Leela Mom, Firoz Dad, and the trustees of Leela Poona Foundation for watering of the potted plant.
Ahmed bhai. Sara.
A friend, a guide, a teacher. Multiple roles can be, you just can't count. She justifies each one of them up to the mark. And in spite of all this, she always has time for your personal visits, emails, and messages. She is there in your happy as well as sad times. She also gives time for every special moment of your life. And we, Leela Girls and Leela Fellows, are blessed to have such a personality as our mom.
So now may I invite our beloved Leela Mom to please address the gathering.
It's the first time I'm going to read a speech. Well, good morning, everybody. Let's all say, wow!
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 We are celebrating our 20th anniversary. Are you not all happy? Wow! I am so, so very happy to be standing here to welcome all of you to this epoch-making event. When we started with 20 girls in 1996, it was impossible to imagine that we will be awarding 1,200 girls scholarships this year. Surviving for one decade was a challenge, leave alone sustaining for two decades and stepping into the third one. This has been made possible thanks to our many partners who have joined the journey as we have moved on. I take this opportunity to thank each one of them. I also take this opportunity to thank all our members of the advisory board, our trustees, committee members, volunteers, the LPF staff, and of course, all our daughters, without whom the foundation would not have been there. They have all worked sincerely and tirelessly to make this possible. Finally, I would also like to thank my soulmate, my guide, my friend, my life partner, without whose unstinted support, it would not have been possible to move on with our mission. Thank you, Dan. The foundation ensures that the girl not only gets education and completes it, but also empowers them with continuous workshops, mentoring is so important, and confidence building programs. All these inputs enable the girl to crack the interviews and get good placements in very progressive companies. Many of our girls are working in almost all companies, not only in Pune, but Pune, Bangalore, and overseas. We have got close to 140 girls working in United States. They are working in UK, they are working in Germany, in Australia, in Netherlands. Wherever I go, I have a Leela fellow who is there to be with me, to spend time with me, and it's such a pleasure to meet all these young blooming girls. We started this journey 20 years back alone, and today we have many partners working with us. Many of our partners are here today in the audience, and I extend a personal warm welcome to all of them. A special welcome to our chief guest, Mr. Anand Talalikar, and our guest of honor, Mr. Shishir Josipura. Both of them are not only our chief guest and a guest of honor in today's function, but they are also our partners in our journey towards a better tomorrow for all of you girls. I also welcome the parents, and I request them that they should allow their daughters. मी तुम्हाला सगळ्यांना मराठीत बोलते की तुम्ही आज इथे आलेला आहे ते फार सुरेख आहे आणि माझं तुम्हाला एकच सांगायचं आहे की तुमचा मुलींना इथे अभ्यास करून द्या, पुढे जाऊन द्या. तुम्ही त्यांचं लग्न सगळे करणार आहे. आयुष्यात आलेलो आहे आपल्याला लग्न करायचं आहे, आपल्याला मुलं होणार आहे, ते नॅचरल फिनॉमिना आहे. परंतु त्यांना स्वतःच्या पायावरती उभा राहून द्या, त्यांना इकॉनॉमिकली इंडिपेंडेंट होऊ द्या. कोणाला माहित आहे पुढे कोणी लिहून दिलेलं आहे काय की कोण बघणार आहे आपल्याला करे. आपल्या स्वतःच्या हातातमध्ये आपल्या इकॉनॉमिकल इंडिपेंडन्स असला तर तुम्हालाही चांगलं म्हण. आठवण ठेवा, तुमचे मुलं तुम्हाला बघणार नाही, मुलीच बघणार आहे.
To call on stage Merin to introduce our guest of honor, Mr. Shishir Josipura, to the audience.
Myself, Ms. Merin Philip, LG 2012, pursuing the course of basic BSc nursing final year. I consider myself to be truly honored to introduce to you a great personality present amongst us today, Mr. Shishir Josipura, who is the managing director and country manager of SKF India. Sir hold mechanical engineering degree from BITS Pilani and is graduate of advanced management program from Harvard Business School. He joined SKF in 2009 to lead its drive towards consolidating its position as the leading manufacturer of seals, lubrication, bearing, mechatronics and services. Mr. Josipura began his career of 26 years at Thermax as a trainee engineer serving in different capacities while overseeing progress of prestigious projects. In 1999, he was appointed as the CEO of Thermax Energy Performance Services. Mr. Shishir is recognized for his deep domain expertise in the field of energy efficiency, renewable energy, and carbon intensity reduction. He has served as the director of Process Plant and Machinery Association of India, that is PPMAI, from 2005 to 2007, and then as the chairman till 2009. Mr. Josipura has always been in touch and in good relation with our foundation. He has always been an active support for us. SKF has organized various field visits for our Leela girls, which I am sure have always been motivating and innovative for us. Sir, it is truly a great privilege to have you amongst us today. Now, I would like to request our guest of honor, Mr. Shirish Josipura, to enlighten us.
Thank you, Mary. That was very kind and very tall introduction. So, good morning. Absolutely. I need to see the energy of Leela in each and every girl, each and every Leela fellow. Yeah. So, it gets multiplied so many times. And I think I start by saying what a yeoman service the foundation is doing to the country. Somebody said, educate a man and then educate a girl and educate a family, and I'm saying you are trying to educate a nation because you are trying to educate so many guys. So as I was thinking there, and I was, you know, these speeches are always difficult things to do, and I'm not very good at reading from a paper. So the good news for you is that there is no paper. The bad news is, therefore, you don't know how long I'm going to talk. Otherwise, you are saying, okay, now only one page is left. But I was thinking, and you know, I, amongst the only hobby which I have kept over a period of time, is to read a lot. And I was reading a book called Chaos. You know what is chaos? We hear about it, right? When there's crowd, there's chaos, there's unruliness, there's turbulence, there's disturbance, and we say it's chaotic. But chaos is a science by itself. And it has a theory which says that when a butterfly, when a butterfly flaps its wings in Shanghai, in China, it can actually lead to a tsunami in New York. That's the theory. A butterfly flaps its wings in Shanghai, and if everything were to go in normal route, it will actually create a tsunami in New York. Long distance apart, huge multiplier. And I think in many ways, here are the butterflies. All of you are butterflies. You are going to flap your wings and lead India to a gigantic change. Yeah? You hold the future of this nation on your shoulders. Yeah? And thank you very much for finding these butterflies. And we'll be very, very happy to support you in any which way we can. Yeah? I think it's very important for you. Other thing I must confess, why is SKF associated? Mary said SKF has been supporting, I have been supporting. And that is because of a weakness that I got, and that is that I can never say no to any lady in my life. Starts with my mother, goes on to my wife, of course, there is no choice there. I have one daughter, and you know, if there's only one daughter, she'll wrap you around your finger, which is what she does. And I still recall, and of course, then Leela said, you do this, you know what I have to say. Yes. I still remember many, many years ago, this is almost 15 years ago, we were returning from a holiday, and we bumped into Leela at Delhi airport. My daughter was about 7 years old at that time. And I said, Rujita, let's go and meet somebody who you should meet. And she says, Daddy, I don't want to meet all your friends, you know, they are so old. They're so old, they're elder, they're like you. I said, yeah, but this one you should meet. So let's go and meet. And then I introduced her to Leela, and I said, you are meeting a pioneering engineer in this country, and take inspiration from her and become an engineer like her and do her proud and do me proud. And you will not believe it, but she said, oh, this is different than rest of your friends. And of course, Leela in her own effervescent way was talking to her and, you know, pushing her, saying, what are you doing? And remember, she was a 6-7 years old, but I'm very happy. She is now an engineer, just like you, and pursuing her MS. So thank you so much for being an inspiration and playing a part. And so Leela played part in life of my daughter. It's only natural justice that I do something for so many of her daughters.
To all the parents who made the difficult choice of educating their daughters.
And it is our privilege. It's our privilege to contribute that one tiny bit to making India's future bright. So be the butterflies, flap your wings, flap very hard, create a tsunami of change, and lead these nations. Thank you very much.
Support, his inspiration and guidance is a source of empowering the young girls. Thank you.
Good morning, one and all. We are in for a real treat this morning. Like many of you, I recognize that the opportunity to hear a guest in person is a rare and extremely valuable opportunity. I'd like to say a few words about our chief guest for today, Mr. Anant Taravlekar. Mr. Anant Taravlekar, who is the president of Cummins Components Group and a vice president and managing director of Cummins India Area Business Organization, started his career with Cummins in 1986 as an intern. Prior to his association with this organization, Mr. Anant Taravlekar completed his bachelor's degree in mechanical engineering from Mysore University and his master's degree from the University of Michigan in 1985, also completing his MBA from Tulane University in 1987. Mr. Anant Taravlekar has held number of positions in India and USA. He served as a financial analyst and held manufacturing, engineering, and product management positions in the engine business unit before joining the corporate strategy organization. He became the chairman and managing director of Cummins India Limited in 2004, and under his leadership, Cummins business in India has grown rapidly. He serves as a member of the Confederation of Indian Industries, Society of Indian Automobile Manufacturers and Automobile Components Manufacturers Association. Presently, he serves as the managing director of Tata Cummins Limited, a 50-50 joint venture between Cummins Incorporated and Tata Motors Limited, India's largest automobile manufacturer. He is a long-reigning MD and CEO of the Tata Cummins for 13 years. He also chairs the boards of three other Cummins legal entities in India and serves as a board member of KPIT Cummins Limited. He has been a well-wisher of LPF and has had a long-lasting relationship with Leela Poonawalla Foundation. It would interest you all to know that he is a very good singer too. Now I request Mr. Anant Taravlekar to address us and request you to please begin with a song.
Thank you. Thank you, Harvey. I think I might end with a song, Vincy. First of all, very, very warm, congratulations, heartfelt congratulations to all of you youngsters here. I'm sincerely very delighted that you have reached this milestone and wish you lots and lots of success. It's a great privilege to be here, especially when you find out that, Dr. Abdul Kalam was supposed to be out here. So clearly, I'm not even going to attempt to try to emulate what he was, etc. I just want to say that, aside from the partnership that the Poonawalla Foundation and Cummins have had, Leela and Firoz are, very good personal friends of mine. So it goes beyond the partnership. We just love each other as human beings and we love to share company with each other, especially with a bit of good fish and some good drinks. So, and of course singing and music, right? So it's a very deep, sort of affiliation, I would say, that is connecting me to this wonderful cause. I think I would agree with my colleague, Mr. Joshipura, and everything that he said. And also, I, like him, also find it very difficult to say no to women. In fact, even I have just one daughter, and she certainly has me wrapped around her fingers also. So we are in the same boat. But aside from that, I will say that very honestly, I am what I am because of the women in my life. Very honestly. It's not that men have not played a role, like, my father, for example, played a significant role. But, clearly the first person was my mother, and the kind of love and nurturing that she gave me is, I believe, what makes me a somewhat loving and nurturing man today. Subsequently, of course, I have a very young sister. She's 10 years my junior. She was also a bit like my daughter, I would say. Further subsequently, lots and lots of females, like Leela, that have come into my life and have really made me a much, much better person, including my wife, of course, and my daughter, but beyond them also, I would say, so many colleagues, working colleagues today, at Cummins and outside Cummins. So I owe a very, very deep sense of gratitude to females because they have an incredible power, and they are able to do things that men just cannot do. I'm not talking about the physical things, I'm talking about things other than that, that even I think men struggle to do. So, you know, what one piece of advice I would give you is don't try to be like men necessarily, unless you really want to, but you know, it's not required. Be yourselves, and you are great in your own right. Song by Kishore Kumar, actually he also gave music for it, and I think the words are somewhat meaningful to where you are.
Aachal ke tujhe main leke chaloon ek aise gagan ke tale jahan gham hi na ho aansu bhi na ho bas pyar hi pyar pale us aise gagan ke tale सूरज की पहली किरण से आशा का सवेरा जागे सूरज की पहली किरण से आशा का सवेरा जागे चंदा की किरण से घुल के घनघोर अंधेरा भागे चंदा की किरण से घुल के घनघोर अंधेरा भागे कभी धूप मिले कभी छांव मिले लंबी सी डगर न खले जहां गम भी न हो आंसू भी न हो बस प्यार ही प्यार पले इस ऐसे गगन के तले
We are giving the similar play to our great friend here today, supporter of Leela Poonawalla Foundation from the very beginning, Mr. Anand Talawalkar, Chairman and CEO of Cummins. Leela Poonawalla Foundation, leading Indian ladies ahead. In appreciation to Mr. Anand Talawalkar, we sincerely thank you, sir, for your constant support. Your inspiration and guidance has been a source of empowering the young girls, including you all who are present here. The Board of Trustees of Leela Poonawalla Foundation, given on 30th October 2015. On your behalf, I'll be giving in a beautiful play.
Thank you, Dad.
Prachi Divekar, Leela Fellow of 2005. I currently work as a lead consultant in one of the Japan-based company, and I'm also working as a freelancer trainer for corporate companies. When I look back exactly 10 years, I was just sitting like you girls, and I actually know how proud you must be feeling right now, because rigorous interviews, tests you must have gone through, and so unfortunately, 10 years experience with the foundation, I have so many wonderful memories with mom, dad, trustees, and when I look back for my personal and professional growth, foundation has been a stepping stone for all my achievements at every milestone. So for example, when I receive the appreciation from our external auditors or senior management on precisely and right time business risk identification, I do realize that it's Inspira or magazine from where I learned to write precise and to the points articles. When I go for training, I do realize the simple tips given in spoken English class. I truly remember all those memories. I carry those for all 10 years now. And I remember I used to attend every other program Foundation used to arrange for us. I mean, I remember the days when we had the restrictions of participants to attend for the program. So I sincerely request you all girls to please participate and attend the weekend programs which mom and trustees are planning to have it for you. At the same time, I do have a sincere request to all the parents that please understand that all of us, all these daughters are meant to do something extraordinary. So, ghar chi kaam and all, they will all do. They are so smart to do that. But they are also supposed to attend those programs which are meant for them. And believe me, this has been helpful.
Yes. We now begin with the most awaited part, that is the Foundation Scholarship Award ceremony. I now request Chief Guest Mr. Anand Talaulikar and Mom to give away the certificate. Ms. Ranjini Chatiya, Leela Girl 2013, will announce the Higher Education Scholarship for this year.
The first category of scholarship being awarded today is for girls who wish to pursue their post-graduation in various streams is Aboli Ghelwar. Aboli has done BSc Zoology and now pursuing MS in the same field from Modern College. After post-graduation, she wants to become a lecturer. Her father is a homeopathy doctor. Vidyapati Devi. Vidyapati has completed her BSc Science and is pursuing her MSc Science from Bharati Vidyapati. After post-graduation, she wishes to become a lecturer. Later, her aim is to open an old age home for her friends and parents' support. Her father has a grocery shop contract. Sayyed Sabuwala. Sayyed has completed BSc Physiotherapy and now pursuing MSc in same field from Rangoon Wala College. After Masters, she wishes to work and support her family. She is a gold medalist in cricket. Her father has retired and has his own business.
I request our guest of honor, Mr. Sishil Joshipura, to please give away certificate.
Aarti More. Aarti has completed her BSc Mathematics and now pursuing MSc in the same field from TC College, Baramati. In 10, she stood second in the school. After her master's, she wishes to become a professor. Her father is no more and mother is farmer. Ashwini has completed BE Chemical and now pursuing M.Tech Green Technology from Institute of Chemical Technology, Mumbai. She is interested in research. She wishes to do a job in that field. Her father is a clerk in Farmgate Pharma. She is a Leela girl
and
now Leela
Chief. Chief Guest, Mr. Anand, a lovely girl, to please give away the certificates.
First girl receiving the scholarship is Afia Siraj Shikalgarkar. Afia is presently pursuing her diploma in education from the MCE Society Junior College, Azam Campus, Pune. After completing her diploma, her goal is to work abroad and study further. Afia's father works as a school van driver and her mother is a homemaker. Alisha Zameen Mirasarkar. Alisha is currently pursuing her diploma in education from the MCE Society Junior College, Azam Campus, Pune. After completing her diploma, she wants to work in a school of a good repute. Alisha's father works as a driver and her mother is a homemaker.
Thank you, Anand sir.
Tehzeen Afleef Sheikh. Tehzeen is presently pursuing her diploma in education from the MCE Society Junior College, Azam Campus, Pune. After completing her diploma, she wants to work and complete her education simultaneously. Tehzeen's father expired last year and her mother is a homemaker. Twinkle Harry Rosaya Samul. Twinkle is pursuing her diploma in education from Meenatai Thakre DL College, Pune. After completing her diploma, she wants to pursue her post-graduation. Twinkle's father works as painter and her mother is homemaker. Zulekha Babumiya Shai. Zulekha is presently pursuing her diploma in education from MCE Society Junior College Azam Campus, Pune. Zulekha's father is vegetable seller and mother is a
home. Now I request Mr. Arun Kumar to please come on stage. And our guest of honor, Mr. Shishir Joshipura, to please accompany him.
Asavari Shinde. Asavari is pursuing her bachelor's in pharmacy from Marathwada Mitra Mandals College. After B.Pharm, she wishes to pursue her higher education as also start teaching. Her father is no more and her mother runs the family with the income from rent. Humaira Tamboli. Humaira is pursuing her bachelor's in pharmacy from St. G.R. Sable College of Pharmacy. After B.Pharm, she wishes to take on job at Rand Vaxi or become a teacher. Her father is a jeep driver. Humaira Khan. Humaira is pursuing her bachelor's in pharmacy from Elena College of Pharmacy. After B.Pharm, she wishes to pursue master's and then start her own business. Her father is car mechanic.
I now request everyone to please stand up for the national anthem.